2021 was dubbed the European Year of Rail, as part of the EU's efforts to tackle the climate crisis. To mark the moment, the Commission launched the Connecting Europe Express, a train that would crisscross 26 countries and showcase the unifying force of rail. Unifying force? During its journey, the Connecting Europe Express had to change locomotives 55 times. Investigate Europe's team of journalists from 14 countries took a ride on the continent's trains to investigate the state of Europe's railways. Paolo left Lisbon at sunrise and arrived in Madrid at night. He had to board four different trains that took 11 hours to cover 600 kilometers. Nico and Lorenzo approached the Brenner Tunnel. When completed in 2032, it will be the longest railway tunnel in the world. Yet to date, no one knows who, if anyone, will use it. Attila and Anna traveled from Budapest to Belgrade to Piraeus, a trade route snubbed for decades by the EU, yet now promoted and funded by Beijing. What did they uncover? Railways seem to be in a worse state than 20 years ago, despite four European Union rail packages. Many domestic networks have shrunk drastically, while international connections have also suffered a big blow. Night trains have almost disappeared. Cross-border online ticketing is often a bad joke. On both domestic and international routes, more than one in two trains is late. So, who killed the train? Was it the forced separation of railway infrastructure from train operations, a rule that exists only in Europe? Was it the privatization and supposed liberalization of the railways? Or, on the contrary, was it big players like SNCF and Deutsche Bahn who stifled competition through protectionism and double standards? Was it national governments who heavily subsidized aviation, car makers, and motorways while neglecting railways? In this whodunit, they are all culprits, and not the only ones. To find out who else has blood on their hands, read our investigations by media partners across Europe.